Okay, welcome to our class. Today in our office, we want to look at the control of stationary and office equipment. I want us to know the meaning of the term stationary. So when we say stationary, generally, the term stationary refers to all writing materials used in an office. All writing materials used in an office. All the writing materials which are used in the office, we call them stationery. So, examples of writing materials. We have pens, we have pencils, we have books, we have papers, we have ink, we have pins, we have the collecting fluids, we have the printed forms. There are so many. A writing material which is used in an office, we call it stationery. So I would like us to look at how you control stationery. Stationery control. How are we supposed to control stationery? So the following guideline can improve the usefulness of the stationery in the office. So when you say control, we mean make sure you don't have little stock, which we call understocking, and you don't have extra, which we call overstocking. So you have to avoid the two. So avoiding understocking and overstocking is what we mean when we say stationary control, or controlling of stock of the stationary. So make sure the stationary should be bought centrally. Should be bought centrally and in bulk. So if you want to use stationery or to cut the cost, make sure you buy the stationery centrally. Make sure you have only one office for buying or for purchasing stationery, and purchase in large quantities. Purchase in large quantities. Also, we are supposed to ensure that don't overuse. Avoid overusing. Avoid overusing of the stationery. When you say overusing, it means you use the stationery even if it is not necessary. Make sure you avoid overusing of the stationery. And also, when you are going to issue the stationery, make sure you receive the requisition for the stationery. You are supposed to eliminate the wasteful consumption of the stationery. Eliminate wasteful consumption of the stationery. If you can realize that the office clerk is not using the stationery in the right manner, it is better to teach that person on how to use instead of wasting the stationery. Like now, the printing papers and the photocopying papers, make sure you use them the right manner. And before you use them, make sure you know the type of paper which you are using.
We learned about the types of papers which are supposed to be used when we write about bibliography. Also, make sure the stock must be maintained as true as possible. The stock must be maintained as true as possible for you to avoid the wasteful consumption of the stationery. Make sure you secure the quantity discount. Secure the quantity discount. By buying in bulk, you are going to receive quantity discount. Those are the guidelines which can guide you when you are buying or when you want to control the stationery. I would like us to look at the how you are supposed to purchase the stationery. I've said if you want to control the stationery, you purchase centrally. So we have two types of purchasing the stationery. We have centralized and decentralized. So when you say centralized, we mean you buy all the stationery is bought in one point. In one point, one office. One office is appointed to do the purchasing of stationery. Like now, the procurement department can be in charge of purchasing all stationery. Stationery mostly they are consumable goods. So they are supposed to be bought by only one office. Then they will supply the other offices. Then we have decentralized. Decentralized. Now each department purchases their own stationery. They purchase their own stationery. But now this one is going to be costly. So we have only two types of purchasing stationery, centrally and decentralized. When we say decentralized, we mean departmental. So every department purchases their own stationery. So when you buy the stationery centrally, now even the storage will be supervised well, and also there will be greater specialization in purchasing, because even the procurement manager can understand how to purchase and how to issue the stationery. So when you are issuing the stationery, if you purchase centrally, make sure you receive a requisition from each department before you issue. Let us look at the control of consumption of the stationery. So as we said, we have so many types or items of stationery which can be put into personal use. Like now the books. The purchasing department, that is now centralized purchasing, they can even take the books for their own use in their houses. So for you to make sure that you control this stationery in the right manner, or you control the consumption, make sure that the responsibility is assigned to a particular person, and then that person must sign the requisitions. That person must sign the requisitions before issuing the stationery. And also, if it is department wise, stationery consumed must be maintained and must be compared according to the departments. Make sure you understand which department consumes more stationery than the other for you to control the consumption. Make sure you appoint one person from that department to be responsible for the consumption or for the issue of the stationery. And when you want to sign the requisition, don't sign the requisition until there is an authority or the authorized person who has signed that requisition before you sign it as the procurement department or if it is centrally. Now, small items of stationery may be kept packed in small quantities. The small items of stationery may be kept packed in small quantities, and also the requisition slip will be accepted for issue on confirmation that the issued stationery has been exhausted. Make sure you know the issued or the stationery which you issued have been exhausted before you issue other items of stationery. Okay, so because I told you the types of stationery, I would like us to look at the continuous stationery. The continuous stationery, the stationeries which are being used all the time, like the printed papers, the printed forms, they are usually used every time. So it is better to use the printed forms so that you can know which company are you getting the stationery from, or which company are you working in, so that you can avoid the printing or the typing of the company name and the addresses. I want us to look at the types of continuous stationery. We have the roll stationery, and we have interfold stationery and pocketed filling. So when you are, for example, when you are copying, you need to have special or standardized forms. These ones are under the continuous stationery. So it is better that the forms are produced in a continuous roll. They are produced in large numbers. When you are producing them, you produce in large numbers. For example, when we are learning about printing, we said you can print more copies. So for you to be economical, make sure you use roll stationery, whereby the forms are produced in a continuous roll and there is no duplication which is being done. And also you can use the interfold stationery, which is perforated and folded flat in a zigzag manner. Okay, let us look at the main uses of continuous stationery. Continuous stationery is useful for any form which is pre-printed. Any form which is pre-printed, frequently used, and needs several copies at the same time. If you use continuous stationery, it means you must have the forms printed before they are supposed to be used, and then these forms need to be used. So many of them need to be used at the same time. Okay, next time I want us to look at the equipment which are found in the office and how they are supposed to be used.